jobs, and they're keeping their spirits up, a little optimistic, trying to do some networking, go to job fairs, and in some cases settling for a job they never thought they would have. Those with jobs in some cases are a little unsettled, especially if they don't have job security.
Companies, they look for cheaper labor and manufacture of clothing, and they left us where we are today.
Martin Arabian remembers being an assistant manager of the Broadway clothing store until it shut down. Heading into Labor Day, he says the job market is still very challenging, even for those getting a paycheck now. And he gave me this warning.
Everybody's reimbursable now, including you, so you better watch out because the market is so big that 100 kids are coming out of universities, a college, seeking for your job.
When it comes to today's workers, Arabian sees the experienced worker in the riskiest place. He claims employers can cut costs and reshape positions on a moment's notice.
They only look at their stack of papers that they have of applications, as simple as that. And they don't have to give you an excuse. They can find any lame excuse to get rid of you and have two more people instead of one. Of course, because the veterans have experience and they have to pay you as you have experience. And by get rid of you, they can hire two more people instead of having just one.
A healthcare worker who loves her job giving in-home care says when she grew up in New York, the job potential seemed more encouraging.
It's changed a lot since when I was younger, like in high school, summer jobs and things like that. You thought it was going to be much better, but you get to a certain point and now the economy's trying to make a comeback, but not fully.
And these days, there's talk of another minimum wage increase or that moving wage target called the living wage. But does it all really add up?
You need a certain level of income. It does not have to be a wage, quote unquote. It could be the weekly income. 40 hours a week and 10, 15 hours of overtime. Makes a world of difference between, you know, 40 hours a week, even if you are getting more for those 40 hours.
And you know, it's not all that gloomy out there. Some workers say they've had some pretty good perks in the workplace. They can bring their dog in. They have some workout facilities. One location gets lunch served every day. And one big Goleta company recently actually had an employee party that involved a carnival in the parking lot with a Ferris wheel, bumper cars, and all kinds of carnival fun as their employee perk. In Santa Barbara, John Palminteri, News Channel 3.
All right. Thank you, John.